Well, you know, this year's edition of Indiana Women's Golf, I think, is going to be really terrific. You know, we had a great run at the end of last year. And what that really did for us, I think, was just give us a really good sense of purpose. We know what we need to do. We know what it takes to get to postseason and hopefully beyond. And the girls coming back are very, very committed to that. So, you know, that culture is already in place. You know, with that being said, this is an entirely new group. And has new challenges, new strengths, new weaknesses, and you know we're getting really excited to head out to Colorado and start our season, hopefully in a very positive note. Well, you know we've had a couple of weekends to qualify, a couple of weeks of practice, and it's been very good. It's kind of a, you know, during this time it's kind of a shakedown. You know, everyone getting back into school, back into the routine. You know, going to class, managing, you know, studying and all that sort of stuff, and then balancing golf and. You know, we've definitely gotten better each day that we've been practicing and in qualifying. I saw a lot of really good stuff during our qualifying, and you know, I'm excited to see how that translates on the course. Our lineup has a really good mix of experience and youth, and you know, Alex is playing in the number one spot, Alex Kong. Junior this year, had a great year last year, really exceptionally strong spring. Played really well in qualifying, very steady, very solid, and you know, just very, very good. Elisa Pierre is in our number two spot. She's a freshman, and she just killed it during qualifying. I mean, she had a great qualifying. The type of player that's very, very steady, doesn't make a lot of mistakes, you know, puts herself in position, and you know, I'm really excited to see what she can do, you know, throughout her collegiate year and you know, this week coming up. Ana San Juan is a senior. She is in our number three spot. She had, again, a very Ana-like qualifying. She's just one of those players that is just really consistent. I can count on her. She's good as gold. And I know when the flag goes up that she's going to put up some numbers, and that's going to be really fun to watch her senior campaign. Erin Harper is in the number four spot. Erin is just a huge talent, hits the golf ball a long ways. Had a record-breaking freshman year, so I'm pretty excited to see, you know, kind of Erin version two as we head into her sophomore year. You know, I think she's much more comfortable. I think she knows what to expect, and I think you're going to see some really great things. Paris Rico is going to be in the number five spot. Not quite what she probably wanted to do in terms of qualifying, but the good part about it was that, you know, in our last qualifying day, she really clutched it up, and that just shows the mark of a great player. I mean, she had to put up numbers when she needed to, and she did, and I think she's very motivated this year to improve on last year. You know, she's strong, she's athletic, she hits the golf ball a long ways, and you know, as long as we can you know, have good decision making out of the whole group, I think you're going to see a pretty good tournament. Teresa is in the sixth spot, Teresa Angedras. She's a senior. You know, she had a very solid qualifying. Anyone, you know, she has kind of had a little bout of illness there during the actual qualifying rounds, and she toughed it out and put up some numbers as well. So, you know, a lot of the same faces that we saw from last year. We had great play from a lot of the girls that haven't made this trip that are going to next week's Ball States tournament. And, you know, a lot of competition. So I think that's good for us, and hopefully it'll bode well as we head into next week. Well, I mean, there's a lot of things that come inherently a little bit more challenging when you go to that, you know, to the altitude, as you said. You know, my time in New Mexico, when you're up there a mile high, you know, you just don't realize how much, how faster you get dehydrated, you know, how much more stress that your body is under, even just walking, you know, 18 holes, you know, let alone 36 in the 36 hole day that we're going to play on Monday. So, you know, we're having the girls hydrate, you know, on that, you know, avenue. I mean, it's just very important to make sure that we're physically ready. And then there's the golf piece too. Is the golf ball goes much farther up there, and so, you know, we've been doing some stuff with the TrackMan to try to simulate. You know, exactly how far the golf ball goes, so we have a good idea on our yardages, and we'll actually take the TrackMan with us, as we do every tournament, to you know, get real accurate carry and roll out yardages, and that'll be a big thing. That's probably the biggest adjustment. And it's not, it's one of those things, it's not a standard 10% type thing. I mean, you know, you're going to hit your farther irons farther proportionately than you are your short irons because of spin and launch and all that sort of stuff. So, you know, there's definitely going to be some adjustments for us. I think it's going to be a great event. We're really excited. The field is strong, it's diverse. A lot of West Coast flavor, a lot of Mountain West flavor, some WAC, some West Coast Conference schools. You know, a lot of teams that we compete against, you know, throughout the course of the year. And, you know, I think you're going to see a very competitive event, and hopefully it'll be good for IU.